This video is a shout out to Carolyn with Homesteading Family. I just watched several of her videos related to lacto fermenting, and I just wanted to send her back my own video, letting her see what I have been up to in my kitchen based on all the fun things that she showed that are going on in her kitchen. So I didn't have any carrots in my garden this year, but we do have a great farmer stand. And so I got some carrots and some of these sugary onions. I put some cabbage in there and to hold everything down. So that is my water and salt mixture in there. Carolyn said for every quart of warm water, you put in 2 tablespoons of salt. I did have lots of good banana peppers in my garden this year, and so I put them in here. Some of them I cut the top off, and some of them I just left whole. I also put in a little bit of garlic that I got from that farmer stand, filled it up with the salt water, and put a cabbage leaf on top along with this seal. I hope that once the fermenting process begins, I can just kind of relieve some of the bubbles this way. I hope it's convenient, and I really want to try to use these up because, like so many people canning, I'm having a hard time finding the supplies. So I did have these and washed them, soap, really hot water, and then prepared my vegetables and put them in there. I do want to share that I did learn quite a bit about salt with Carolyn. She talked about salt being kind of in its natural state where it doesn't have any additional non-caking ingredients and it hasn't been bleached. And so I have this really pretty pink Himalayan salt that I've been using directly on my food. And then I did buy some sea salt. It's a light gray, which tells me that there's a good mineral content in it. And it's been fun to really sprinkle that on food as it's cooking and just having it prepared. This table salt, I've used it like my whole life. And so has my mom. And I see now that it's bleached and has some anti-caking agents in it. I'm not saying that it's a terrible thing and I'll never use it again, but I like that I've been introduced to some other things related to salt. I also want to say thank you, Carolyn, for letting us know what we would do with these lacto-fermented vegetables because we are a family that eats a lot of rice, and so I think these vegetables are going to taste great with our fresh rice. I do also have some tomatoes. I've canned quite a few tomatoes this year, but if I get a few more of these pretty Romas and cherry tomatoes, I think I'm going to try the fermented tomatoes as well. Finally, I want to say I'm composting all of my vegetable scraps now. So I have leaves bagged from last year, and I'm layering them in my own compost with my kitchen garbage. And so it's just been great learning from Homestead Family videos. I've recently signed up for their email, and it's just been wonderful to connect with them. Thanks, Carolyn, for all you're doing. Keep up the great work.